A pleasant good evening to you all from the Danbury Ice Arena, the regular season finale between the Danbury Hattricks and the Elmira Mammoth here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Both these teams will be on the road and in action next weekend. They'll be taking part in other games, but this is the final game of the regular season here at the Danbury Ice Arena. And then next week, we launch into the playoffs. Danbury with a regulation win or a Columbus regulation loss secures the regular season championship for the Federal Prospects Hockey League. Though they will need just a little bit of good fortune to go their way to sew up a regular season spot against a team from Elmira that is intent on trying to spoil their fun and gave a tremendous effort and tremendous fight in last night's proceedings. No Tristan Mock in the lineup for Elmira this evening. He's replaced by Thomas McGuire, who draws in on the forward spot. Also, no Tobias Ogic. He sits tonight to catch some rest. Igor Borshev takes his spot in the lineup, draws back in after a bit. Otherwise, it's the exact same lineup for the Danbury Hattricks. Let's throw things downstairs to public address announcer Dre with the starting lineups and the player awards as voted on by the fans of the Danbury Hattricks.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your Danbury Hattricks!
Hey fans, welcome to the Danbury Ice Arena. 13 years of professional hockey. unreal. Unreal to be here. Wow. So tonight is our annual player awards. Before we get to that, we want to recognize the people who really make this happen. The crew up in the media relations booth, Chris Lynch, Jack Kiedis, Calvin Savoia, Samantha Zorcher, Jim Cierney, not here tonight. We've got our PA crew, DJ Pat Burnett, Andreas Cloud, Connor Sweeney, Ed Lockwood, probably got a few others back there, always helping out. We got our crew on the bench. We got Griffin, equipment manager. How about that North American League team? 2 weeks in a row, these boys are doing some great things. Way to go. Assistant coach, goaltender coach, Matt Boyne. Best looking guy in the building, a member of the 2013 Danbury Whalers, Tyler Knowlesworthy, assistant coach. Captain America, assistant coach John Krupinski. Our trainer, Eric Kapopoulos. Trainer, Amy Schneider. Our medical team, Dr. Simonello, Dr. K, Dr. DiLorenzo, Dr. Hartsburg. I think that's it. So I'm going to announce here we got the mayor of Danbury, Mayor Dean Esposito. We've got our head coach, general manager, and ownership partner, Billy McCreary. We got Chris Lynch. Yeah, let's give another one for Chris Lynch. Handling all the social media. We got the stat crew. We got Leo on the camera. JP on the stats. Emma, Brookfield Bobcat over there. Alexandra, social media TikTok specialist. We got photographer Chris Rush. We got Nicey over there. Beautiful photos all year long. And we got Mike Peterson behind the bench representing the Danbury Police Force. That's the crew. I think I got everyone, but that's the crew that makes it happen, and we appreciate them and everything they do. And before we get started, we've been going, I'm going to turn it over to the mayor for a few words to the fans.
Thank you so much. Fans are the best thing that Danbury has here with the hat tricks. I want to thank you all for being here tonight, every night. Cheer them on. We've got a powerful team this year. Let's go, Hatchers. God bless you.
Billy is going to speak twice tonight, but before we get the awards, I'm going to turn it over to the guy who I think should have been the coach of the year for this league, should have been the second time he won it. But here he is, head coach, general manager, Billy McCreary.
Thanks for being here tonight, every night. These guys pour their hearts and souls into what we do here for you. So postseason's upon us, and we're really excited to represent the city the way we always have. Thanks for being here.
Okay, we got a couple awards. I did forget one person. Yes. And you know what? If it wasn't for him, none of us are here tonight. Okay? Because him and his brother, he's a very shy, humble guy, but Jim Diamond is over there. And let me tell you, fans, without Jim Diamond, none of this is happening tonight. bench right now are in 77, Dmitry Kuznetsov. So I love recognizing the guys who won it. Just shows the history of this place and the team. The guy who is the Rookie of the Year, he accomplished something that's pretty extraordinary, because in the 13-year history of this building, there's not many guys who have scored 30 goals. And as a rookie, he did it. Rookie of the Year, Mike Marchison.
This team,
who's the most known, there's a good chance we're going to say this guy, because he has connected with so many kids, so many families, and he just put in such an effort. The Danbury Hatchet Award goes to Zach Bevelam.
Please welcome Sir Christopher Lynch.
Thank you.
Bob DiTullio and his family, Coltech, for getting behind this promotion. Thanks for being here to the Buck family. All right, time for the first Buck tonight. She's the coach for the day. We've got Melissa.
Tricks in Mammoth about set to go. Danbury in the home orange jerseys. The word Danbury diagonally across the front of the jersey. They'll be going from left to right across your internet waves. The Mammoth in the road whites. Lucas DeBenedette will hop out to center and take the face off. Luke Richards will be his jousting mate. DeBenedette wins it. The puck is dropped. We're underway. From the Danbury Ice Arena. Hattricks looking to close out what has been a phenomenal home season. 23-2-2. DeBenedette with the first shot on goal. It's sent a little bit wide. Abdella will knock it down. Puck bounces up to the circle. DeBenedette turns, looks for it across. Gonzalez will turn and fire it on. It catches the back end of the net. Abdella will poke it along. 30 seconds gone by, and already a couple of shots on net for the Hattricks. Marchessault lays a check. Jelenskis will walk in at the circle. Shoved aside by Xavier Abdella. Anderson can't control it, can't do anything with it. Gonzalez looks for the pass forward for DeBenedette. Has Marchessault with him, throws it to him, walks in, and scores! You'll see it again. Marchessault receives the pass from DeBenedette. A good drop into the right area. Dangles and puts it in. Faked as though it was gonna go center and puts it in the back of the net. The Hattricks lead 55 seconds into proceedings. Hope you're having fun, everybody. Ruiz wins the draw. Danbury didn't even make a personnel swap before they got a goal to go in. Here come the Mammoth looking for an answer. Stevens almost did. Wilson had played over to the left post so much that the net was open. Here comes Ruiz. He'll try to flip it over. Schmidt can't knock it down. Pamaleon will just play it forward. Sits at the blue line. Schmidt looks for the long pass ahead. He's got it, and it connects with McGuire. DeBenedette the goal, or sorry, the assist. That's his 14th assist of the season. Gonzalez gets an assist as well. His 29th assist of the season, his 32nd point. Gola will drop it. Robertson will pop this out. Two on two they come. Igor Borshev glides in. Borshev can't control the pass. Sheehan was jumping into it as well. He'll play the puck against the end walls and look for somewhere further to go with it. Spun against the crunch. Borshev will try and knock it free. Popped up to the wall and looking for the exit. Kicked off the skate and lugs on across the red line, flown in. Brian Wilson, very smartly, will just put the puck away and we'll get the first non-goal stoppage of play. Holy smokes. Gullo and Sheehan on the dot. We're 2 minutes and 14 seconds in. Marchessault, the game's first goal. Robertson to Kuznetsov. He'll look for it forward. Caught Borshev on the way in, received and picked up by Kuznetsov. We'll throw it around. We have a whistle. This is going to be a penalty. Our players didn't see the official at all behind him. This is going to be a charging penalty against Brendan Sheehan.
Fans, get ready for the hat trick penalty kill.
So first time tonight, the hat tricks go to the penalty kill. First time Elmira goes to the power play. They were 0-6 in last night's proceedings. Remember, a regulation win for Danbury, and they sew up the regular season championship. Elmira is 17.5% success rate on the power play, tied with Columbus. Only one spot above Danbury. The hat trick's an 81.6% success rate on the penalty kill. Richards will throw it over to the left circle. Turns and fires. Wilson caught a piece of it. Sanchez. We'll walk this up. Sanchez holds it. Hands off to Richards. He'll throw it across. Sits at the top of the circle. Turns and fires. The save he's made by Brian Wilson, and he'll cover up. A busy night of hockey for the sport writ large. The hat tricks and all the action in the Fed. One piece of it. The men's NCAA D1 National Championship is tonight, of course. A Nutmeg State team is represented in that game. Quinnipiac University Bobcats are playing Minnesota. Every single NHL team takes the ice tonight, so a showcase night for hockey. One minute left to go on this power play. Mammoth will ring it around. They've got 43 seconds left to go. Campbell leaves it there. Yao mucking in the corner. He'll ring it to Benedette. Tries to get to it and does and clears it. Proudlock will settle it. Campbell comes up to set it up. Long pass ahead for Stevens. Dropped for Gullo. He'll gain the blue line. Thrown across. Chances wild. The shot kicked back up to the circle. Save for Brian Wilson. Mammoth actually lead the shot counter 3-2. Amesbury seeing some penalty kill time. Gullo will wind up and put it down to Soilus. Left circle, final 5 seconds. Soilus, the kick save by Wilson. Hamileon will ring it around. Too far for Ruiz. Sheehan not there for it either. And Proudlock very smartly will just put his glove on top of it and not allow for any more chances at any funny business.
Hey fans, we gotta recognize even more people. From Jim Brundage, Timmy, Kyle, Mason, and Max, all on the ice crew, making this ice the best it's ever been. That's the Danbury Arena Ice Crew.
Up to the point for Gonzalez. Abdella will have to go and chase it, and does. He's using it as a shield. Sanchez in defense on him. Up for Borshev. Takes that spot with Ojic, and in Ojic's spot. Puck bounces up. Borshev tried to throw it up to the point. Abdella will get to the loose puck. Abdella will walk it to the circle. Thrown in tight. Knocked down. Delenskis will clear it up to the blue line. 5 minutes gone by. Gonzalez knocks it down. Richards is offsides. So that'll bring us to the under 5 media timeout. Quick pause back in a moment from the Danbury Ice Arena. Word from our friends at the Holiday Diner. You want the best milkshake you ever had? You want to taste greatness? Well, hit the Holiday Diner on White Street and feast off of their menu. It's breakfast, lunch, and dinner with George and the crew. Check them out on White Street at the Holiday Diner. Hat tricks off to a good start tonight. Zamboni crew getting a shout out from Herm Sorcher and very greatly appreciated for all the very fine work that they have done to try and get through the season and maintain this ice sheet here at the Danbury Ice Arena. An awful lot of events held here. From everything from a whole bunch of hockey games at the pro and junior level to motocross events as DeBenedette will throw it on and they almost connect again for their second goal. Robertson tries it and Marchessault can't finish it off. That line, the Marchessault, DeBenedette, and Radcliffe line has created a bunch of the offense so far tonight, including the only goal to this point. Marchessault tried to funnel it across for Jared Yao. He'll have to work it in the corner. Bounces over to DeBenedette's stick. McDonald will walk it, try to put it on towards the net. DeBenedette takes it against the wall. Drops it, Marchessault, in tight, Radcliffe. One pass too many. He threw it back up to the slot and could not connect with Lucas DeBenedette. Soilus will glide his way on, or sorry, McGuire will glide his way on. Pass picked off by Campbell at the center ice logo. Campbell will walk it, shoot it wide, and beyond Brian Wilson's goal. McKittrick can't control the long outlet pass. Settled at the blue line and thrown up for McDonald. A little bit over McKittrick. This is not going to be an icing. McGuire will paddle it along. Gordy Bunnell's the first guy to get on the loose puck. Bunnell will work it around for McKittrick. Hands off Bunnell in front. Shot on by Johnny Ruiz. The backhander is snuffed out by Thomas Proudlock.
Fans still checking out some groups in the building. We got the Bulgaroli family is here tonight. Ashley A. Crew is here.
6:32, the time gone by. Danbury started off this game. Only 55 seconds went by before the first goal went in. Shots are even right now for a piece up on the screen. And Danbury has just taken their second penalty of the game. Johnny Ruiz is going to be held off, and he kind of knew it immediately. Ruiz is going to sit down. Danbury 1-for-1 on the penalty kill so far.
We want to wish Jackson a happy birthday today. Jackson, a happy birthday.
Clean draw one, bounces down to Jared Yao. He'll look for the clear and gets it. Skied the length of the ice. Elmira this season has allowed 6 shorthanded goals, including one of them last night, and we're about to get an even up. Elmira has taken a penalty. Jared Yao keeps this puck rolling. And just as soon as we get, there was a holding penalty against Ruiz, and just as soon we get a penalty whistled against the Mammoth. Nathan Campbell is going to sit down for 2 minutes, so we'll get a minute and 35 seconds worth of 4-on-4 skating time. The ice is going to open up a bit. Puck down, the faceoff will go back out to empty space. Danbury is going to get a truncated power play out of this as well after the 4-on-4 time elapses. Gonzalez, the pass forward for Borshev, gets shoved off the puck. Stevens and Maratee going for it. Sheehan separated from the puck, bounces up to the circle, thrown across. 12:30 the time remaining in the first period. 1-0 Danbury. Mammoth looking to even it up. Gullo glides in, the shot over the crossbar. 4 players working against the boards. Abdullah Gullo, Shannon Stevens, won by Stevens. Schmidt, ring this one around. Bounces off the Zamboni door to Brendan Sheehan. Drags through, Borshev, hands off for Sheehan. Everyone waits at the blue line and now goes. Sheehan jostling, Marate lost his stick. He'll kick it and hand off to Ricard Zielenskis. Gets by one man, another penalty going against Danbury. We'll get the touch up with 11:44 left. Three penalties in short succession here. And the hat tricks. See Brendan Sheehan go off to the box. We're gonna get 23 seconds worth of a 4-on-3 power play for the Elmira Mammoth, and a chance for them to tie the game up right here with 11:44 to go. A clean faceoff win, and McKittrick shoves Gullo off the dot. Soilus will pull it and work it. Shot right on goal. Save made by Brian Wilson. Jensen will put it on. It's a slashing penalty against Sheehan. 5 seconds left on the five on the 4-on-3. Yao will hold it, throw it up to McKittrick. Ruiz out in front, McKittrick running with him. McKittrick throws it across and underneath Riley Robertson's stick. He'll throw it around to McKittrick. Ruiz comes away with the puck, has a nose for it. Ruiz glides in. Ruiz, puck sat at the top of the circle. 11 minutes left, and Campbell's penalty comes to a conclusion, which means a minute and 10 seconds more of an Elmira power play. By technicality, their third of the day. Marchessault will run out. Got a shorthanded goal last night, and we have a Mammoth player down in the hat trick defensive end of the rink. Luke Richards down in a heap. And what has been a messy and at points undisciplined penalty for that period for the hat tricks. Sheehan's down, or Richards down. Former hat trick being attended to by Aaron, athletic trainer here tonight. Let's pause for just 15 seconds here on the Danbury Hat Tricks YouTube channel.
In a relentless world, connected but alone, trapped by illusion. But there is another path where the battle to belong begins.
He's been nominated so Luke as Richards one of the best looking, most
is going to head off.
Most handsome fans in the Federal Hockey League from 207, Mike Tapatazzi.
So this ultimately is going to be no harm, no foul, just an inadvertent hit. And we're going to keep on going. The hat tricks have exactly 1 minute worth of power play time still to kill. They'll knock it down the line. Sanchez thrown across for Chris Marate. Rung around the boards. Gonzalez takes a whack at it. Gordy Bunnell pickpocketed across, and they score. Luke Richards with another assist and gotten across for Dalton Anderson. His second straight game in Danbury with a goal. And we're tied up at one apiece. Shots are 7-4 in favor of the Mammoth, and now we're tied up at one goal apiece. This is that setup, this is that play. Richards got to the loose puck, threw it, and a great finish. So tied at one apiece. Danbury took too many penalties and ultimately ended up paying the price for it. Coming up on the halfway mark of the first period, Warship tried to hand it off for Kuznetsov. Emma Leon's there for it. Under 10 to go. Hard check by Sheehan.
No line amendment. Power play goal scored by number 20, Dalton Anderson. Assisted by number 44, Luke Richards.
The scoring on that is very, very easy. It's Anderson's goal.
9 minutes, 38 seconds.
His 15th of the season. His fifth power play goal. Sanchez gets an assist on it, as does Luke Richards. Richards is 22nd assist of the season. I'll give us the under 10. Quick pause back in a moment from the Dan Burry Ice Arena. Friends at Hartsburg Chiropractic. Dr. Matt Hartsburg is an official member of the Danbury Hat-Tricks medical team. Hartsburg Chiropractic is a cutting-edge chiropractic care right here in your backyard. Check out Hartsburg Chiropractic and get on the road to a pain-free hockey season. Sheehan will take the face-off against Gullo and win it cleanly. Pamaleon lost it. Sanchez throws it up to the point on net, bounces wide. Emma Leon, work it off the glass. Puck came free for a second, whacked back in. And they'll get the pass ahead for Kuznetsov. Runs into the circle. Kuznetsov shot, save made. Puck bounces up to Borshev. They'll whack it around. Robertson will handle it, bounce it low. Robertson will try it again. The puck stays in his feet, thrown on towards the net. Kuznetsov gets to the loose puck, turns, fires. Shot blocked by Chris Marate before it ever had a chance of going on net. And a whistle sounds. It's a mammoth penalty. An interference call going against Elmira. And it looks like Justin Schmidt who's getting called for it. Word of honoring for Sonia from Section 200, Yale's mother-in-law, so a big honoring for her. And we hope that the family are all okay. Hat-tricks go to the power play. Amaleon will play it up to Gonzalez. Wants the shot on, it's tipped by Stevens and into the protective netting straight upstairs. Draw down, Pamaleon will play it. Pamaleon holds it. Hands off to Ruiz. McKittrick will step in. McKittrick will put it back up to Gonzalez. Gonzalez up, winds up, fakes the blast. Ruiz will step it to Gonzalez. Minute 30 left. Hat-trick's power play has been a bit of a problem. They'll try it, in tight. McKittrick, maybe a few too many stick handles. Pamaleon will get to the loose puck. 40 seconds gone by. Ruiz winds up, wants to blast it. Didn't have it. They'll try the wraparound. Up to the circle. Shot by McKittrick. And into the awaiting glove hand of Thomas Proudlock. Danbury got some needed shorthanded scores last night, but only a 16.9% success rate on the power play. Draw down up to Radcliffe. Ruiz will step in. Radcliffe thinks about the shot. Radcliffe threw it behind Lucas DeBenedet. Borshev will come over and play it. 1 minute left to go on the man advantage. Bunnell hands off. Radcliffe the shot. Locked aside and sits harmlessly in the corner. to Benedett, already with a point tonight. Hands off for Bunnell, low for Borshev, threw it to DeBenedett, and off his skate. Namath will get the clear, it's through Sheehan, and all the way to co-goalie of the year, Brian Wilson. Jacob Radcliffe will run it forward. Across the red line for DeBenedett, pulls up at the line, he'll bring it in, knocks straight up. Ford, holding the puck against the wall, four players there, a fifth helping out in Bunnell. 18 seconds of power play time left. It's through Sheehan and goes all the way back down to Brian Wilson. He'll put the puck against the apron of the goal. Jared Yao will walk this up. Long pass ahead, connects with Johnny Ruiz, walks in and sails the shot a little bit wide to the right. The power play comes to a conclusion. Pass thrown across by McKittrick. Got to it for a second. Schmidt threw it on. Yao caught it. Walks it to the bench. Thrown on to Ruiz, makes the shot, tries it upstairs, not there, a little too high. McKittrick settles it against the half boards, walks in, shot into Proudlock's glove, and Ruiz jostling up with Ford. Ruiz wanting to go, Marchessault getting into the mix as well, and I don't think we're going to get any more than that. Well, our first little scrap, our first bits of fisticuffs so far this evening. Danbury Hatrox debuting the mascot. What's the ruling going to be? Danbury has taken another penalty, and it's against Johnny Ruiz. So Ruiz takes his second penalty. So a 2-minute minor for that little scrap up to the circle and now to Campbell. They'll hold it and work it low. Elmira's lone goal has come on the power play. It's a goaltender interference penalty. We're running into Proudlock. Abdullah will try and work it free. Campbell holds it, plays it up to Campbell at the point. Soilus waiting for it. He's got it at the circle. Soilus will swap spots with Stevens. Hands off for Gullo. Kittrick defending him. Soilus with the dip around to the circle, shot punched out by Ruiz and thrown by Gonzalez. I'm pretty sure that's not allowed at all, and the officials blow it dead because, look, that was kind of ludicrous. So Gonzalez just throwing the puck like
the
it's a baseball game.
Hockey League fan has been charged with assault and battery in Binghamton, assault and battery in Watertown, assault and battery in Danville, assault and battery in Port Huron.
5:44 to go in the first period. Gonzalez looks like he's going over to the penalty box, and yep, he's getting a 2-minute minor. He's gonna sit down for a penalty. All the fans throughout the building are getting their plaudits.
There is no truth to that. Lee is the nicest guy you'll ever want to meet. Please disregard all the tattoos.
So a minute and 19 worth of a 5-on-3, and the Hatricks just getting undisciplined here. Shot on, saved by Wilson. Sneaks underneath Yao's stick, and Sanchez will set this up at the circle. Steps it to the high slot. Looks for some room, he'll drop it to the point, receives it back at the circle. Steps in, across and underneath Chris Maratee's stick. And now the Hatricks just have to survive a big hit by Riley Robertson. Are they going to call it? They're calling it another penalty. This one going against Riley Robertson for an elbowing call. It'll be three hat tricks in the box. And the fans letting the officials have it. You'll see it again. Robertson with the hit, and respectfully, that doesn't look like an elbowing penalty to me. 5:16 to go. This 5-on-3 is gonna hang on for a while. That 2-minute penalty against Robertson doesn't kick in until the Ruiz penalty ends, if I understand that correctly. So we are gonna be at this special team setup for a while, which means the penalty killers for the hat tricks have a lot of time to go. Tied up at one apiece, 45 seconds on this segment of it. Sanchez will step in through Wilson, stop, and Xavier Abdella will clear this out. And now what do we have? D'Angelo ran directly in to Brian Wilson. So what are we gonna have here? Are we having another penalty? The whistle did sound. And yes, D'Angelo is being escorted out. D'Angelo is heading off for this. Got hit, fell down, fell right on top of Brian Wilson. The Elmira fans don't like it, but this is being ruled as a goaltender interference penalty. This portion of the penalty listing in the score sheet is just gonna be kind of a mess. And worth noting, the Gonzalez penalty was ruled as a bench minor for a delay of game. So that's what that was. Right now, we are at a 4-on-3 power play sequence still for Elmira. Everything makes sense, I promise. Bunnell on the faceoff dot. Elmira wins it. We're now under 5 minutes left to go in the first. Well, if you like goals, we have a few of those. If you like litigation in your hockey, boy, do we have a lot of that. D'Angelo for goalie interference. 17 seconds left on Johnny Ruiz's penalty. Campbell will hold it. Work this around, shot saved by Wilson. There's a lot of animosity building up here. We'll take a breather and come back on the other side of the under 5 media timeout here at the Danbury Ice Arena.
Right off the jump, we've got ourselves a line ball. Robert Hyde across the club.
We're gonna have a fight at center.
Ovech with come a couple on. Of big rights. He scores!
A word from our friends at Peach Wave of Bethel. Located on Greenwood Avenue in Bethel, Peach Wave is your go-to place for a quality treat. Yogurt and toppings, it doesn't get much better than that. Catch a wave. A peach wave. 4:34, the time to go. Let's see if we can catch up on the goal scoring or on the way that this game has worked itself out. 1-1, and the string of penalties have been close to endless so far. The officials are having a chat. Golo's talking to the refs, making sure that they know what exactly is left to sort out. And to just one. Frozen yogurt from our friends at Peach Wave of Bethel. They really do have a fabulous business going. Stevens will step in, low for Soilus. So Robertson's penalty begins and the hat tricks remain with only three players on the ice, but fortunately Elmira took a penalty too, so it's only a 4-on-3. This is extended power play. Gullo up top, the shot, blocker, save made. Campbell throws it on from a rough angle. Stevens at the top of the circle. And walking and looking low for Soilus. 10 seconds left to go on these penalties. 2-on-1 chance. McKittrick off for Yao. Yao winds up. McKittrick in, scores! A shorthanded goal for Daniel McKittrick. And the Hat-Tricks take the lead. All of the penalties in the world amount to little. McKittrick, the pass across to Yao. It's a two-man game. Yao, the pass to McKittrick and the backhander to get it through Proudlock. That happened right as the special teams play expired. So I don't know if officially that's going to be counted as a shorthanded goal. Functionally, it's a result of one. Actually, yes, it is. Danbury still is down to a 5-on-4. No? Yeah, no, we're back to a 4-on-4 situation. I'm very confused by what all the penalties are. They've changed one of the players who are up on the boards, but whatever the result of the penalties, the Danbury Hat-Tricks have taken the lead. Daniel McKittrick, what a wonderful pickup he's been. His 25th goal of the season, his 51st point in his 52nd game, came over from the Mississippi Seawolves and has been a tremendous offensive lift for this team. Has slotted in wonderfully well alongside that top group of Gordy and Johnny. Yao will get the assist on that goal. It'll be his 32nd assist and 34th point. Sheehan handles and chip it over the blue line. Takes it, picked off. Richards in alone. Richards scores. Luke Richards, the power play, or no, the even strength goal at the 4-on-4 spot. And Richards, a solo goal. His 15th of the season and already his second point tonight. Plays with an aggressive chip on his shoulder against his former team. And seconds after McKittrick puts the team ahead, Richards ties it up. Bunnell with the hit. We're gonna be in for a good one here this evening, folks. Richards will fly it in. Stick down by Wilson. Pamela on, he'll work it around for McDonald. Lobbed high and over the glass.
Hey, Pat, we got another
with Tor with 2:45 left to go.
He is the man who started it all in 2004. He was 17 years old. He was the general manager, president, one of the founders of the Danbury Trashers. 2006.
AJ Galante in the building, the general manager of the Danbury Trashers. The originator of professional hockey here in Danbury. McDonald will look for the pass forward for Ruiz. Glides it up to the circle. Ruiz hands in. Backhand shot a little bit high. And Malayon will keep it on. Gullo tried to control it. Walks in. Stevens dips through. Stevens threw it up to the slot. Hamileon's there for it. The whistle sounds. Stevens goes down against the end boards with 2:23 left. This game scheduled for a 7 o'clock start. We are already at 8 o'clock. Stevens heading off. Stevens just immediately turns and goes to his team's bench. So what's the ruling on all this going to be? Doors open, so they're scratching off some of the blood that came out. Stevens just immediately went out. Looked like he had a bloody nose, so hope that he's all right. Ruiz is out to have a chat with the officials. Ruiz has his questions about what's up. The scoring to this point in the game as follows. Michael Marchessault, a goal 55 seconds in, a power play goal for Dalton Anderson at the 9:38 mark, and a shorthanded goal for Daniel McKittrick. Luke Richards with an even strength goal. ...33 seconds after McKittrick's shorty. So Richards and Ruiz, we'll meet on the dot, and we'll do it proper. Richards wins the faceoff. Soilis will walk it at the circle. Soilis will play it low for Gonzalez. Hands off for Xavier Abdella. And looks for the outlet pass. Richards' goal is an unassisted goal. Ruiz splits the defense. Ruiz, save made by Proudlock. He'll dive on it and cover the puck. The captain of the hat tricks, giving his effort. A couple of other scores around the FPHL. 3-2, Binghamton in the lead over Delaware. Port Huron in Watertown. The Wolves trail the Prowlers 2-0. Danbury's actually going out that way, out to Port Huron next weekend to close the regular season. And Carolina leads Columbus 1-0. Radcliffe will fire it. Proudlock stops the shot. 1:50 the time remaining. Yao will kick it and settle it. Angelo can't do much with it. Well, shoves away from the puck. Robertson. Over Marchessault turns it over. D'Angelo wanted to connect with Golo, and Yao tips the puck away. Sanchez takes the check from DeBenedette. Yao will glide it forward. Jacob Radcliffe back from Marchessault. Up top, doesn't connect for the shot. Radcliffe holds it. DeBenedette called for it. Yao winds up for the shot. It's wide of the post. DeBenedette still with it. He has been on a mission the last couple of games. In tight, Marchessault held up. Can't do much with it more than that, and we get a penalty. Who is this going against? We get a couple of shoves against Michael Marchessault from Stephen Ford. Ford being ushered off to the penalty box, and yep, this looks like a power play going in favor of Danbury. 1 minute, 1 second left to go in the first. Danbury 0-4 on the power play so far tonight. They'll send the top unit out to try and get the lead before intermission. Ruiz will win the faceoff cleanly. Pamela on. He'll hold it and put it low. Pamela on. He'll hand it low for McKittrick. McKittrick lost it, got it back. Gonzalez at the point. 45 seconds left in the frame. McKittrick off Ruiz underneath Marchessault's stick. Gonzalez will hold it. Give it low and dip through.
To number four, Stephen Ford. He receives 2 minutes for holding.
Top one at Pamela on.
Time of the penalty, 18 minutes. Holding penalty.
Ruiz will get it low and cleared the length of the ice with 23 seconds left. Wilson will get the pass ahead for Marchessault. Batted back for Gonzalez. Marchessault in a penalty against Danbury with 14.8 seconds left while on the attack. Zach Pamaleon is going to head off for the 2 minute minor, a minute 13 of 4-on-4 skating that's going to carry into the second period. This clip, yep, this what you're seeing right here. Hamileon running right through. This is going to be ruled as an interference penalty, I think. So with 14.8 seconds left, that is the ruling on that. 14.8 seconds left to go. Sheehan will hop on and take the face off against Luke Richards. He'll try and win it cleanly. McDonald will take it for a walk. Put it up for Borshev. Borshev, the long pass for Sheehan, can't control it cleanly. Final 5 seconds, they'll get it back out to neutral ice, and that is that. Or, no, wait a minute. Nope, there we go. Yep, the final period has burned down. Just stopped for a second. 2-2, an eventful first period to say the very least. Penalties, litigation, goals, some goals in style. A frantic sequence and a frantic rush. We're gonna take a breather and come back in a little bit from the Danbury Ice Arena. We'll be talking to one of the players. We'll be talking with Michael Marchesson during the intermission, and we'll give you score updates around the FPHL. Quick pause back in a little bit from the Danbury Ice Arena. tied up at the end of the first period between the Hattricks and Elmira Mammoth. Michael Marchesson got the first goal of the game, and I got to speak with him on between the periods. Let's hear what he had to say. 2-2 between the Hattricks and Elmira Mammoth at the end of the first period. And I'm here with Michael Marchesson, who's voted Rookie of the Year for the Danbury Hattricks and organization. And Mike, I just want to ask first about winning that award and what's that mean to be represented and honored among a good class of rookies coming into the Danbury Hattricks organization this year?
It's an honor for sure. I can't give too much credit to me. I got to give it to Billy. He's given me that opportunity, and the team I have just made it easy.
Let's talk about that goal you had only 55 seconds in. What did you? Michael Marchesson at the end of the first period. He got the opportunity to win the Rookie of the Year award and had the great honor of being one of the guys after Dmitry Kuznetsov, who won it last season. Marchesson opened up the scoring. Let's give a quick look around the FPHL's scores. Teams are in action tonight. Early on in the second period, in the other game that matters as far as the Hattricks standings chase is concerned, the Carolina Thunderbirds lead the Columbus River Dragons 1-0. So that's how that works itself out. Remember, a Columbus loss in regulation time will result in the Hattricks winning the first period, well, winning the regular season championship. Port Huron and Watertown doing battle as well, early on in that game as well, or at the end of the first period. That is a 2-0 game in favor of Port Huron. Binghamton is in Delaware. It's 4-2. Black Bears in the lead. There's this game, which is 2-2. And then there is Motor City and Mississippi at 2-0. Motor City in the lead. So we'll take a breather and come back in a little bit with the start of the second period between the Hattricks and Mammoth here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel. First intermission coming to a conclusion here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Let's run through the scoring of this game pretty quickly. 4 goals in the first period. 2 for each side. 55 seconds went by when Michael Marchesson potted the first goal of the frame. Opened that up with a nice feed from Lucas DeBenedette. Dalton Anderson answered on a power play. Luke Richards had the assist to set him up. Joshua Sanchez as well. By the way, Lucas DeBenedette and Kyle Gonzalez getting assists on Marchesson's goal. Daniel McKittrick scored a shorthanded goal at the 16:19 elapsed mark of the first period. And Luke Richards picked off a pass and tied the game up at two apiece. They have been either in a hat-trick lead or in a tie game throughout the course of the night. It's still a pretty full penalty box as Zach Pamaleon was called for a late hit, which ends up putting it at an even 4-on-4 skating time. The penalties so far in this game have been close to relentless. 11 minor penalties between these two teams to open up proceedings. Most recent ones, Stephen Ford took a holding minor and Zach Pamaleon took a tripping penalty. So we have 58 seconds worth of a 4-on-4 skating session between the Hat-Tricks and Mammoth. All the Hat-Tricks on the bench bang on the boards. Stevens and Ruiz will take the face-off. Off the tie-up, Stevens will take it away. Soilus holds it. First 10 seconds gone by, using the net as a screen to get Gordy Bunnell off of him. Thrown around on the right side, Ruiz tries to get to the loose puck, almost forces the turnover, and does take the puck away. Bunnell tried to work it on Soilus, the only guy who could get to it. Soilus up the wings. Soilus will throw it deep and takes the check. Bunnell will get free. Bunnell with Ruiz on his left. Bunnell shot, glove hand saved by Thomas Proudlock. 20 seconds left to go on the initial penalty before we got to our pause. Shot scores. Campbell, top left corner over Brian Wilson's shoulder, and the Mammoth take their first lead tonight. You'll see it again. It's a good feed from behind the net and a top left corner shot. Just a wicked, wicked setup. That's Campbell's sixth goal of the season. Had one goal in his three games played with the Carolina Thunderbirds, and his other now five have come as a member of the Elmira Mammoth. Marchessault and DeBenedette will run on. Marchessault glides in. Marchessault lost control of the puck. DeBenedette was camped out in front of the net. Marchessault will handle it. He'll spin again. Marchessault in. Marchessault shot stopped. DeBenedette gets tripped up. He'll throw it out to Robertson in neutral ice. Hat-Tricks are now on the penalty kill and spending it, attacking as though they are on the power play instead. Only 23 seconds left to go on the Pamaleon. Luke Richards, by the way, his third point of the night. Shot sailed up top. In is Borshev. Save off the glove by Proudlaw. Threw it up to Sanchez. Fly out over the middle, Pamaleon got in the way of it. Hat-Tricks do kill the power play, but give up an even strength goal at the 4-on-4 time. Thrown in tight, chance for D'Angelo, can't do anything with it. McDonald will run it on. McDonald walks in, creates some room. McDonald, a shot save made by Proudlock. This is going to turn into an icing call against the Mammoth, and a pretty easy one at that. It's the final regular season game of the season here at home for the Hat-Tricks. Amesbury tries to put it on towards the net. Taken away by Gullo. Robertson looked at free, didn't know where it was. Stevens in. Stevens will poke it to the corner off his pads, off the pad of Ryan Wilson. Amesbury held up. He'll try and fly it out. Got it to the boards. Yao will kick it to his stick. Elmira in the lead, 3-2. Ford will hold it. Wanted to get Johnny heading downhill. Ruiz will take this, dip it for Amesbury. Amesbury, his shot blocked by Ford. Ruiz winds up and blasts it. Kick save by Proudlock. Martius on with the check. Abdullah kicks it to DeBenedette, glides in. Lucas DeBenedette, kick save made. Martius on, in, through some traffic. Martius on, will play it up to the point. For Gonzalez, winds up and blasts it. Shot kicks the pipe off of Amesbury's tip. Golo with the, absorbs the contact of Diamond Hands Amesbury. Four minutes gone by. Gonzalez just holds this puck, and now we get a penalty. Where is this being ruled against it? We're getting no penalty on this? Only slightly confused by everything that is occurring, but oh well. Draw one by Sheehan. Borshev will try and work it in. Kuznetsov can't free it. Puck too far ahead for McGuire. McDonald, the pass ahead for Sheehan. Borshev will whack it back to Sheehan. Sheehan, the shot, kick save made by Proudlock. He's having another very, very good game, all things considered. Two goals that were gotten in were excellent efforts by Marchessault and McKittrick. Hip check by McDonald. Hamileon will hold it against the apron of the goal, spins his way free. Sheehan dips it, Kuznetsov, Borshev in, shot. Proudlock, another save. He's already faced 20 shots so far tonight. Sheehan will put it around for Riley Robertson. Robertson will glide in. Left it for Sheehan, spinning with it. Richards tried the takeaway. Kuznetsov. Sheehan calls for it. Sheehan in tight, bouncing off of Proudlock's face and bounces across neutral ice. Yao will fling it across. Ruiz running in. Puck found its way in behind Blake Cudmore. Soilus and on ahead, flung in. Stick up. Who's this going against? It's an elbowing call. We'll take the under 15 here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel at the Danbury Ice Arena. Course level here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Our friends at Fala Coffee. So a minor penalty going against Riley Robertson. 2 minutes up on the board for the hat trick defenseman. Another penalty going against Danbury. Only the 13th. Stevens will put it low. It's an elbowing penalty against Robertson. Golo will hand it off. Golo looks for it. Spins and holds it. Dips it through the shot. Sailed too high. Three seconds gone. The officials deliberating more this one about where the faceoff should be. Golo and DeBenedette hopping on the dot. Lucas DeBenedette has been creating a number of good offensive chances. And of course, he'll win the faceoff. Jared Gow will glide in. He's got a point as well so far tonight. Gow will hold up. Bounces off of DeBenedette's stick. Campbell holds it. The puck will sit against the open net. Soilus will run it. Soilus runs on. Held up at the circle and played to the blue line. Stevens. The top shot locked down by Wilson. Can't cover it. 1 minute left to go on the power play. Stevens the shot and stop. And Wilson blows it dead. And we get a pile up. McDonald mixing it up. Yao trading some shoves. Stevens and Marchessault going at each other. Soilus and McDonald. Oh, we got ourselves a fight. McDonald going at it. McDonald going at it with Soilus. Away from the play. Yao had already been called for a penalty. And we got a separate fight that nobody was paying any kind of attention to. I feel bad for Dre, the public address announcer, who has to attempt to keep track of the long litany of penalties. Ruiz and Gullo will keep chatting. There are four Danbury hat tricks in that penalty box. They're having a second mammoth go in. Noah Wild is going to sit down. This. They've thrown a 2 minute minor up on the board for Marchessault. McDonald is going to get a fighting major. So, this is how all of this started. Wild right on top of Wilson and then separated. And we get a pile up, we get a little bit of a shove. Yao trading some shoves. Going to be separated from Wild. Both of those guys sitting in the box. Xavier Abdellah now coming in to get some stuff over to the four guys sitting in the box. That's off the replay. Marchessault and Stevens you see chatting. And then McDonald and Soilus all this while just trading punches with each other. So again, the hat tricks have another 5-on-3 penalty to kill. Marte will walk it down to the circle. Marcia's on a 2-minute minor, plus the fighting majors. This has certainly been something, hasn't it? They give a minor penalty to Wild. They give... It's a mess of penalties. 7 seconds left on the 5-on-3, and the Hatricks will clear it. They've got another minute and 3 seconds worth of regular penalty time to kill. Robertson jumps across and runs back to the bench.
Hatricks penalty to number 8, Johnny McDonald. He receives 5 minutes for fighting.
Yep, McDonald.
Hatricks penalty to number 4.
And Soilus will get 5 minute fighting majors. 2 minute roughing penalty against Yao. 2 minute penalty against Wild, also for roughing. McKittrick will get the clear.
Number 27, Stavros Soilus. He receives 5 minutes for fighting. Mammoth penalty to number 7, Noah Wild. He receives 2 minutes for roughing. Time for penalty is 6 minutes.
Stevens will run forward. Stevens across the blue line. Mammoth already have power play goals so far today. One for the day. Jelenskis dips through, creates some space, shoots it, save made by Wilson, and got the clear by Zach Pamaleon. Long pass ahead, Stevens fields it, kicked, and controlled, tried it by Radcliffe. All of this special teams time finally and mercifully ends. Borshev will run on. Puck lost and ran away from him. Knocked down through Radcliffe. Robertson with it. DeBenedette tried to make a play on it. The puck bounces into the Mammoth bench. Jelenskis and DeBenedette. A little stick check, a little shoulder check. And more discussions, more happenings and goings on. The Hatricks furious. Johnny Karpinski, the assistant coaches, gesturing wildly. This is going to be a 2-minute slash. It's going against Jelenskis, so he'll sit down for the two. And Danbury gets their power play. Ruiz on the dot to start this off, 11:02 to go. Danbury looking to tie the game. Elmira goal early on in the second period. Former Hatrick Luke Richards with 3 points. He got an assist on Nathan Campbell's goal. Really nice goal by Campbell. It's a 2 minute slash. This will be icing by the Hatricks. They play it from just on the wrong side of the red line. With 10:41 left to go. And that's one you really can't be mad about if you are a Hatrick fan. You can't be annoyed with the officials on that. You can just be annoyed with mishap on the decision for where to play it from. He stays out there. Anderson has one of the 3 Mammoth goals tonight. Lost the faceoff. Himalayan. Slides in, and Leon across the blue wall. Pulls up, looks for someone to go with it. Up for Ruiz, Ruiz winds up, shoots it, and it's a little bit wide. McKittrick, and Leon. Gonzalez waiting for it. McKittrick will get it up to the wall. Ruiz, down low for McKittrick. 50 seconds gone by on the man advantage. Gonzalez at the blue line. Walks in, low for Marchessault, McKittrick. Steps through Marchessault, Drew Proudluck out, who kicks it to the corner, and the Mammoth will get the clear. Proudluck being aggressive, but making a play happen. Danbury will swap to the second unit. DeBenedette will come over and pick up the puck. Hands off for Bunnell along the wings. 40 seconds left. Bunnell glides on. Bunnell drags, shot wide of the net. Sheehan settles it. Radcliffe off the bench. Going with five forwards right here. Shot on, blocked down. Puck loose, tried to get the clear, and they do. Gullo doing the honors. 20 seconds left. And this Danbury Hattricks power play continues to be a bit of a problem for Danbury. 10 seconds left. Sheehan. De Benedette in front. Borshev the shot. Proudlock stops it. And Borshev in the middle of a tie-up. 6 seconds left on the power play. We have the under 10 media timeout. We'll take it. Quick pause here from the Danbury Ice Arena. Word from our friends at McCabe's Classic Deli in Brookfield. They're ready to serve you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Grab and go, or ready to heat and eat. McCabe's is food with a Bronx flair. The Hattricks win tonight. Everybody is one to buy one, get one free. Breakfast sandwich from McCabe's Classic Deli. 6 seconds left to go on the Jelenskis penalty. Ruiz won the faceoff. Yao wanted to get the shot through, couldn't. The penalty expires, and the Hattricks power play still has some work to do. Kuznetsov retrieved the puck. Amesbury will work it deep. Richards played up to the boards, bounces out. This is going to be an icing. 8:46 left. Mammoth in the lead. They're looking for their first victory against the Hattricks this season.
Special welcome, Amigo Grande is here tonight. Amigo Grande.
Richards won the faceoff initially. Richards will hold it at the blue line, pitched high. Amesbury take a whack at it. Puck was loose. Amesbury will sprint to it. Campbell won the race to it. Tried to work the turnover. Ruiz will take it. Shot. Knocked upstairs. Fighting Majors for Soilus and McDonald come to a conclusion. They head back to their respective benches. De Benedette will hop on the dot and take the faceoff against Gullo. 24-19 are the shots currently. Ruiz wanted to hand it off for Marchessault in tight. Ruiz score! No, De Benedette scores it! Benedette, a spark plug for the Hattricks. You'll see it. It's a clean face-off win, and then a frantic tie-up. They wanted to get it low for Marchessault. He couldn't get it cleanly, and De Benedette just chips it and plays it up over Thomas Proudlock to tie the game. 3 goals apiece. De Benedette calling for it, he goes down. It's his second point of the game. He got an assist on Marchessault's goal. Radcliffe tried to get in behind him. Flipped up to the red line. Knocked free. Benedette and Radcliffe will handle it. Radcliffe across the blue line. He lost it. Marchessault in. Marchessault glides on shot. Save made by Proudlock. This line, Marchessault to Benedette Radcliffe line has been on fire the last couple of games. Sheehan tipped it to neutral ice, and Chris Marate got to the puck first.
And there he goes! Scored by number 3, Lucas DeBenedette! Assisted by number 80, Michael Markusen! And number 44, Jacob Radcliffe! Time to go, 11 minutes, 46 seconds in the second period. DeBenedette for Markusen and Radcliffe at 11:46.
Tied up against the goal line and covered by Proudlock. Smart decision. Kuznetsov had the chance to make that play in tight. The scoring on that goal at the 11:46 mark of the frame. DeBenedette the goal. Marchessault on the primary assist. Radcliffe the secondary assist.
The Orvieri family is here. They're here tonight.
Dalton Anderson, the faceoff win. Gets through Panaleon, goes to neutral space. McDonald will work it free. McDonald the pass ahead, connects with Kuznetsov. Borshev, too far ahead for him. Pocket picked by McGuire. Panaleon back to try and defend against him. Shoulder to shoulder with him. McGuire wants it in front, bounces, and Wilson had no idea where it was. Panaleon will give it backwards for Brendan Sheehan. He's very, very, Brian Wilson is very lucky that that didn't trickle across the goal line to return Elmira to the lead. 3 goals apiece. Kuznetsov walks in, hands off for Borshev. Igor Borshev will turn and hand off for Kuznetsov, who shoots it, and it's stopped by Thomas Proudlock. With 6:04 to go. Borshev hit the boards hard.
Fans, Danbury Westerners raffle tickets on sale through the end of the second intermission. Enter for a chance to win team gear and season tickets. Once again, on raffle through the end of the second intermission.
Riesel hop on the dot. He'll go against his old friend Richards. Clean win. For Ruiz, Danbury tries to return to the lead. To Benedette with the equalizer. Yao fumbled it, got through Richards. Low, well, Bunnell wanted the tip and Proudlock snuffs it out. This has been a very staccato feeling second period. Yao kept it in at the blue line. Ruiz walks it, hands it. Ruiz, the shot, it goes wide. Loose puck against the wall. Robertson, the shot. Ruiz tries it, and Proudlock somehow kept that out.
Special shout out to Denise Klova and Caroline Eva.
5:36 left to go here in the second. Each team with a goal. Off the tie-up, the shot by McKittrick sailed too high. Danbury won't touch the players on the ice. They'll keep them out there. .5:30 left. Puck bounces. Marate will hand it backwards. Ruiz will play it low for McKittrick. Wanted it for Bunnell, couldn't connect with him. Sanchez and D'Angelo try to run it on. Abdellah snuffs it out. Bunnell on it. Bunnell will play it low. McKittrick can't get there in time. Gullo wins the race to it. Puck bounces over Sanchez's stick. Patrick still on the move. Hamilton on the shot. Save by Proudlock. Nobody on the back door to punch it home. Puck knocked straight upstairs by Ratcliffe. De Benedette goes down away from the play. D'Angelo glides in, gets denied. A chance with Ratcliffe and De Benedette at the blue line. Walks it, De Benedette. Ratcliffe, the shot too high. Had the right idea, just sailed a bit too high. We have the under 5 media timeout. We'll take it here at the Danbury Ice Arena on the Danbury Hat Tricks YouTube channel.
Right off the jump, we've got ourselves a line ball. Robert Hyde drops the puck.
We're going to have a fight at center.
Levesque with a couple of big rights. He scores!
Word from our friends at Set Fitness. Set Fitness, the official gym and training center of the Danbury Hat Tricks. Pump iron or tone up. Don't get sand kicked in your face. Join Set Fitness and be the best version of you. Three goals apiece between the Hat Tricks and Mammoth.
All right, hey, I think we can do it, everyone.
4:38, the time remaining. De Benedette hopping on the dot. He'll be going against Dalton Anderson. This line has been the best offensive driver so far today for the Hat Tricks. Clean face-off win for Lucas De Benedette. Hamileon will work it around the boards for Marsh. Hassan thrown in tight. The net comes clear off its moorings. Proudlock kicked it off. Couldn't connect with it to keep it on. Postseason will be beginning on April 21st. Hat Tricks will be on the road for game one of the postseason. They'll be at home for games two and three, if necessary, of round one of the playoffs on the 22nd and 23rd. Tickets will go on sale on Monday. And McDonald's shot. They'll play it on for Ratcliffe at the slot. Score! McDonald, the play, it bounces to De Benedette. This will be De Benedette's third point of the game. Ratcliffe, his second point, is a goal. Got through Proudlock. 4:14 left to go in the second. And what is the stoppage in play for? I'm extremely confused right now. Are they gonna add some time back on? They weren't ready to go, or what do we have? Well, however they rule it, Danbury has reclaimed the lead. 4-3 the score. And only a little bit of time back on, and we'll keep going. Sheehan gets by Ford. Borshev waits in front. Sheehan will take it behind the net, swoops in. Bad angle shot, that didn't go in. That didn't cross the goal line, says the officials. Wow, that's a very unfortunate bounce for the Hat Tricks if it just didn't go. Sheehan will play it around for Borshev. Rolled in by Soilus. He'll settle it on the goal line extended. It does Wilson. Puck free, Soilus takes it away. Out in front, picked off. Robertson leaves it for Yao. Jared Yao up to Borshev. Sheehan, across the blue line. Sheehan for Borshev, drops for Kuznetsov, sails the shot a little wide. Sheehan can't settle the bouncing puck in time for a clean shot. Still on his stick, hands off for Gonzalez. Diving low, Gonzalez thinks of the wraparound, turns, fires, can't get it cleanly away or with any sort of energy. Kuznetsov. Hold it and work it low. Sheehan will step in. Sheehan, some space. The shot, save made by Proudlock. And he'll keep it as is. .254 the time remaining. Ruiz on the dot. Wins it from Anderson. Bunnell leaves it for McDonald. Good eyes, good vision for Thomas Proudlock to see the puck through all that traffic. Draw goes to the opposite half boards. Amesbury holds his own in the corner. Bunnell.
Danbury goal.
Nice to work free. Ruiz wants it in front. Radcliffe the goal as they are announcing it in arena. This is going to be an icing call against Elmira. McDonald will get the other assist.
14 minutes, 46 seconds in the second period. Radcliffe from the Benedict and McDonald in 15:46.
.226 left to go in the second period. Hattrick's in the lead. Yao laid on, wanted the tip from Ruiz, and it goes a little bit wide. Not the right idea. Four players, up goes to the circle. No one knows where it is. Stevens does, he'll flip it high. Amesbury got a hand on it, kept it on the blue line. Taken out by Dalton. Anderson runs across the line. Anderson wanted to work it on. Takes down Robertson. No penalty whistled for that. Amesbury lost the puck. Sits on the blue line. At the circle. Turns. Fires. Wilson with the save. Yao will grab it and go. We're under 2 minutes left to go in the second. 4-3. Danbury in the lead. Bunnell will get to and lob the puck on. Proudlock wanted the pass forward for Stevens. He couldn't connect with him. Pinballing puck. Marchessault will play it up to the circle. Wanted Radcliffe. Didn't get him. Minute 20 left. Abdella will knock down the long pass for Richards. Rung through. Gonzalez will sit it against the apron. DeBenedette. Hands off. Long pass ahead, goes nowhere. Gonzalez flipped, backhanded for Abdella. Across to Benedette. Handles, tried the drop pass and nobody was there in the slot for where he was trying to go with it. Fans on it, hard hit. Officials let it go. Jelenskis lost it. Radcliffe forward for DeBenedette. Off sides they rule it. .45 seconds left. Danbury with two goals this period. They are calling a penalty against Jelenskis. So the Hattricks will go back to the power play. Faceoff will be in the offensive zone for Danbury. And, well, actually, no, they're not going to the power play. Abdella's going to hop off, too. Abdella yelling across the penalty box at Jelenskis. These will be matching minors. So matching minors for Abdella and Jelenskis. DeBenedette wins the faceoff and walks on. DeBenedette drags through, didn't have it. Sheehan will play it up to McDonald. DeBenedette the tip on it initially, couldn't control it. Stevens will play it for Soilus. Soilus will run it across the red line. Tried to walk it on, goes down. Another hat trick penalty. .23 seconds left. So Pamela on is heading off. This more than likely is going to carry into the third period. They're trying to work out the scoreboard right now. Leon's penalty is they're updating it to a 4-minute double minor. They've upgraded that penalty from a simple 2 to a 4-minute double minor. Okay, so that's up on the board. This is going to be an extended penalty kill for Danbury. Clean win for Gullo. This will be a 4-on-3 power play. Off the pipe by Campbell. Very nearly tied the game again. Campbell, the walk it. Campbell, Wilson with the stop. Brian Wilson continues his excellence this season. 8 seconds left in the second. We're talking with Lucas DeBenedette at the intermission time. So should be talking with head coach Billy McCreary. Draw is down. McDonald will work it off the boards and out to empty space, and that is that. A double minor for Ice sticking on Zach Pamela on this out. We end the second period. Patrick's get two goals. It's 4-3. Danbury in the lead. DeBenedette and Radcliffe the goals. Nathan Campbell the lone goal for Elmira. Brian Wilson holding on late on in that frame to keep it at 4-3. So we'll take a breather. We'll throw things down to ice level for the shootout. TK's American Cafe for a couple of their free wings. We'll come back in a little bit with some words from some of the players and from head coach Billy McCreary. Don't go too far away.
American Cafe shootout here. I'm with Jimmy over here.
Jimmy is going to take a shot. He's going to try to win 5 free chicken wings for everybody. Now look, TK's has 76 different flavors of wings. Great place to go. They got beer, they got wings, they got TVs. Are there any baseball fans in the building? Any Boston Red Sox fans?
Thank you.
Yeah, we got two. We got 67, 1967. St. Louis Cardinals won the World Series. 223. That's not bad, that's a bowling score. Couple winners, $100 each. That's Todd Maserati, Alfa Romeo. You can claim your prize at the merchandise stand.
Thank you.
Intermission here at the Danbury Ice Arena. We are joined by the head coach of the Danbury Hattricks, Billy McCreary. And Billy, I just want to take a moment before asking about this individual game, just reflect on the season and the way it's gone through. Only two losses here at home in regulation time, two overtime losses. What's it been like playing at the Danbury Ice Arena this season?
Just like it is every season. It's it's a special arena, special place to be, and you know, it's been a special season, as you guys have seen here this year.
Oh, we've been privileged to get to see everything that's gone down, and the fans are always treated to a good show. And let's turn the attention to on the ice, and especially Lucas De Benedet and how he's performed. I actually just want to hear how you guys managed to find him, because he hadn't been playing professional hockey for a good long while before he got here.
He hadn't been playing this year, and he actually played with Kyle Gonzalez in college, so we had some feelers out there, and you know, the timing worked out, and it's been great having him here.
And also, good to see you have your daughter Ayla McCreary as well. Good to see that she's doing well as well.
Thank you. You want to say hi, Ayla? No.
No. No. the first lady of the Hattricks in a lot of ways. As far as the individual game tonight, what do you think the feeling has been on the bench? Because it seems like a kind of contentious playoff atmosphere between the two teams tonight.
Yeah, for sure. It's been back and forth, and you know, obviously a penalty-riddled game here. So it's tough to get into the flow, but you know, we should be used to that at this point in the season with what we got on the ice, and we just got to buckle down here for 20 minutes. Put our sticks away, forget about the officials, and play Danbury hockey.
And also, I'm just going to ask about Brian Wilson. Made a couple of saves, especially on a couple of those five-on-threes to keep it at just a one-goal game at this point in time. And not a ton of shots, but the ones that he has faced, he's handled pretty well compared to the amount of shots that you've thrown on Thomas Proudlock. Just how has he handled all this pressure, and how has he handled his job in net tonight?
No, he's been fantastic. I mean, I think we're doubling him up in shots right now, and I don't know, what do they have, two or three five-on-threes? So,
yeah.
You know, he's been excellent. Our guys are playing well. We just got to stay out of the box and, you know, put the sticks away. Let's use our feet. You know, any slash, any hook, any check right now is being called. So, you know, we just got to fight through it and win a hockey game here.
I noticed when I was putting the line sheet together, I didn't have to change that blue line at all, the defense core. I've barely changed that defense core much over the last couple of weeks. Just talk about how they've grown into their rhythms and they've grown into their pairings and their partnerships in the last couple of games.
They've been unbelievable. And, Dollar's out of the lineup tonight. We're just kind of making sure his body's ready to go for playoffs. But all of them have been fantastic. And we really, you know, with ZP, Zach Penelayan back there, you know, he's a forward playing D for us. And he's just dynamic, whether he's playing forward or D. And I got to tell you, I think out of our 6D, we have four rookies. And, you know, to be sitting first in the league, it's just unbelievable to see what these guys have done. And, you know, I got to imagine that we're going to lose a lot of these guys next year. And it's a testament to the work that they've put in here.
And a testament to you, and a testament to Dave Smith, who won one of the Founders Awards. I actually wanted to ask about your getting to work with Dave on this season, because he's one of those guys who doesn't really get talked about in the scouting staff.
No, he's been fantastic. And, you know, we were able to get Dave from Binghamton. I think it was a big loss for them. And, you know, he's been instrumental in bringing a lot of our talent here this season. So, you know, it's great that the league recognizes him, and any chance that, you know, we get to represent the league, we take it with an honor. And, you know, it's been a tremendous season working with Dave, and I know he pours his heart and soul into the Federal Hockey League. So nobody more deserving than him.
One last question before I let you go. What's the message to the guys in the locker room ahead of the third period?
Yeah, control our emotions here. Play Danbury hockey. We play rough. We play tough. We support each other. We play with speed. We play with skill. And we win hockey games. So that's what we expect here in this 20.
We'll take a breather. Come back in a little bit. Coach McCreary, thanks for coming on upstairs.
Thank you, Sir Christopher.
Quick pause. Back in a moment with the third period. Second intermission coming to a conclusion. Let's give you a quick look at the scores around the FPHL as the teams are coming out onto the ice. Binghamton is in Delaware tonight and leading that game 8-5. Port Huron is up on Watertown 2-0 early on in the third period. In the economic hub of upstate of the North Country in New York, Mississippi leads Motor City 4-3 in Biloxi. And in the game that most matters directly to the hat tricks tonight, the Carolina Thunderbirds lead the Columbus River Dragons 2-0 about midway through the third. If that game goes final and that score, that result has not changed, then the Danbury hat tricks will have secured first place for the regular season in the Federal Prospects Hockey League for the 2022-23 season. In fact, that score has now changed. Carolina has increased their lead to 3-0. So 3-0 Carolina in the lead of their matchup. Hat-tricks need either a win here in regulation or a Columbus loss in regulation to secure first place in the division. And they are on the precipice of having both things occur. Four-three the score. A litany of penalties, including a couple of five-on-three power plays, going for the Elmira Mammoth. Minutes up on the clock. Mammoth going from right to left across your internet waves. All the players hopping into the penalty box. They're resetting the penalties up on the scoreboard. It'll be a 4-on-3 for the next 1 minute and 14 seconds, and then it's going to be an elongated regular 5-on-4 power play for Elmira. The puck is dropped. We're underway from the Danbury Ice Arena. These two teams are very, very likely to be playoff opponents in round one. And so here we are, trying to sort out tonight's proceedings. Mammoth with a 4-3 power play. Stevens will wind up and fake the shot. Campbell will put it on McKittrick. We'll clear it the length of the ice. We'll have 40 more seconds at this unusual setup as far as the penalties are concerned. Stevens will hold it on his side of the blue line and go. Drops for Campbell. He's got one of the three Mammoth goals tonight. Wilson out of his net, plays it around, blows a tire. Richards turns and scores. The game is tied at 4 apiece, 55 seconds in. Well, Luke Richards, a 4-point game against his former team, and ties the game. And it's a whole new game now. So now we get a deliberation as to whether or not Somebody's coming out of the penalty box right now. Abdella's heading back into the box, and Sheehan will hop on the center ice face-off. We are still at a 4-on-3, or a double minor. I'm not sure why we're still at this point, but we are. Sheehan will ring this in. Danbury is going to have to kill off the remainder of the 5-on-4. Walks in. Richards is free. Richards whacks at it, and no room for it.
And we've got the winner for the
four goals apiece.
From the Nahal Chiefs. Blue ticket number 5067586. That's 506.
2 seconds left on this unusual situation, and then the full Pamaleon penalty setup. Soilus will set this up. Minute 34 left of the penalty against Pamaleon. Gino D'Angelo and Nathan Campbell get the assist. Soilus glides on, shoots the shot a little too high. Puck will bounce out. Sheehan sprinting in. Borshev running with him. Sheehan in front. Can't connect with Borshev to finish off. It would have been a pretty nifty tuck play. Cross the line, hands off for Gullo. Loose, Borshev lifts the stick. Borshev and McDonald running 2-on-2. Sheehan acting as the trailer. Sheehan, the puck slips underneath his stick and he blows a tire. 3-on-1 for the Mammoth. Robertson back. Anderson can't control the puck, it's underneath his stick. Rung through, Borshev catches up. Robertson will sit the puck right on the apron of the goal and just take his sweet time with it. De Benedett was open. Robertson will move it a little just to keep it moving. And now Robertson will fly it. He caught it right off the railing in front of the 200 section level. So that is going to be a face-off back in the Danbury end of the ice, I think. And it's going to be a delay of game penalty against Riley Robertson. Seconds now of a 5-on-3 power play for Elmira, and a golden chance for the Mammoth to take the lead. That's a bad choice of plays. So 25 seconds left on this. Campbell will step to the circle, winds up, fakes the shot. Wilson, the save, puck is loose. Can he get a cover on it? Wilson's glove is clean off his hand. He shows it to the officials and they blow it dead. That's just an automatic whistle. Nothing more you can do about it. You have to blow that dead. His glove hand came clean off and you have to blow it dead. Richards and McKittrick, and they'll square up to the blue line. Steps to the left, Gullo the shot, tipped wide of Wilson. Richards will settle it. A wicked game for Luke Richards. Winds up, shoots it, blocked. Save made by Wilson. First part of the penalty expires. Pamaleon jumps back into the mix and gets a stick on the puck and flies it down to the Elmira end of the rink. Long pass ahead, Yao will whack it deep. Proudlock out of his net. Four for the score. Two goals for Danbury in the first, two in the second. Two for Elmira in the first, one in the second, and now one in the third. Up to Campbell at the point. Bunnell with a whack at it. DeBenedet will catch it. Can't get it through Campbell. Gonzalez completes it. Old friends in college. D'Angelo glides in. 40 seconds left on this power play. DeBenedet will clear it the length of the ice. Golo to the circle. Handles it. Sheehan will poke it free. Sheehan decks Golo, and we get a penalty. This is, where is this going as we get a tie-up as well? This has been a contentious, feisty game. Brendan Sheehan is going off as well. This is going to be another Danbury penalty. Brendan Sheehan will sit down. So 21 more seconds of a 5-on-3. We will be 6 minutes and 6 seconds into the third period before we get back to even strength hockey. Robertson's penalty about to expire. Soilus up to Campbell. Richards already with a goal, and Wilson will put the puck in his mitt. And now Brian Wilson has to shine to keep this game tied up. It's a high sticking call. McKittrick and Gullo on the dot. Abdullah fans on the clear. Robertson's penalty is done. He'll jump on to help kill this off. McKittrick will carry it out. McKittrick couldn't control it through Campbell. Stevens will come over and make a play on it. Stevens at the circle. Golo handles. Up to Campbell. Campbell will leave it. Wilson handles and plays it for Abdullah. Stapled into the corner boards. One minute left to go on Sheehan's penalty. Campbell blocked by Bunnell. Opposite circle, Wilson the save. Second chance, not there. Whacked at on the apron of the goal. Spinning down is Golo. 45 seconds left on the power play. Golo will turn and fire. Wilson the save. It'll bounce to the wall. Soilus will hold it and play it up for Campbell at the line. Campbell will walk it, give it to the right. Point shot stopped. Abdullah will fling it the length of the ice. 20 seconds left in this unending parade of penalties to start the third. DeBenedet denies the advance. D'Angelo gets shoved off the puck. Soilus there to help him out. Sheehan is out of the box. Blocker saved by Wilson. And that takes us to the under 15 media timeout. We'll take a breather, come back in a moment from the Danbury Ice Arena here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel.
Right off the jump, we've got ourselves a line ball. Robert Hyde drops the puck.
We're going to have a fight at center.
Levesque with come a couple on. Of big rights. He scores!
Oak Ridge Waste and Recycling has roots in the community for all your needs, residential and commercial. Oak Ridge is the official sanitation partner of the Danbury Hattricks. 4-4 the score with 13:52 the time remaining to be played.
He is the winner of the Hattricks jersey, courtesy of the Nottawak Chiefs.
Give you a few scores from around the league. Binghamton in the lead, 8-5 over Delaware. Port Huron facing Watertown, 3-0 in that game. Motor City and Mississippi, it's a 5-4 Seawolf advantage. And Carolina leads 3-0. That game inches closer and closer to completion. Shot bangs off the apron of the goal. Hamileon tries to work it up to the point. Sanchez will spin and look. Up to the blue line. Shot on, saved by Wilson. Mammoth on the move. Gullo to the point. Fans on it. Marchessault will carry it out. Radcliffe wanted it running with him. Marchessault, nifty glove hand, save by Thomas Proudlock. Draw down, save made by Proudlock. Gonzalez will hold it. And it backwards for Xavier Abdellah. Puck sits on the apron. McKittrick threw some traffic. It's at the circle. Bunnell wanted to work it on towards the net. Richards comes over to try and make a play on it. And all the years that a federal hockey team, from the times when it was called the Federal Hockey League to now when it's called the Federal Prospects Hockey League, no Danbury team has ever won the regular season championship. In fact, dating back to the Trashers, who won a division title, never had the best record in the league overall when they played. McGuire shoots it, and that'll go up top. The only one, the Whalers never did it, the Trashers never did it, Mad Hatters never did it. The only other team to ever pull that feat off and play in the Danbury Ice Arena is the 2015-16 Danbury Titans. They had the most regular season points that year, made it all the way to the finals in a 57-game season. Up for Radcliffe. No icing there. This will find its way around for Zach Pamaleon. In front, wanted the tip. It's a little bit wide of Proudlock. We tick under 12 to go. Pamaleon will settle it. Puck ran. Trying to dice his way forward. Marchessault forward. Marchessault dips for McDonald. In tight to Benedette. Rolls off of his stick. We've got a penalty, and this one is going against Elmira. This is one of the tightest called games I think I've ever seen this season in the league. Sanchez is heading off. 2 minute penalty. It's a hooking call.
Get ready for the power play.
Weasel hop on. Danbury, one of the lowest performing power plays so far this season. Weasel play it up to Gonzalez. Winds up for the blast, it's blocked. Gonzalez low to Pamaleon. Around, tipped by Ruiz. Follow-up chance for McKittrick, not there. All of Danbury's goals have come either even strength or shorthanded. No power play goals tonight. They have a minute and 24 left on this chance to get one. Marchesson already lost the puck. They play it up for Gonzalez. Steps in. Louise low and in tight. Bouncing puck. Marchesson turns. Nobody there for it. The chant in the Danbury Arena is "Let's go hat tricks." Marchesson. Play it for Pamelea. Gonzalez, the shot, blocker save, rebound is loose and cleared. Proudlock is down now to his feet. Gonzalez, cross to Ruiz. Down low, turns, wanted to fire, worked off the puck. Can they get the clear? Yes, they do. Marchesson on the tie-up. Wilson will knock this puck down and hands off for Gonzalez. 35 seconds of power play time left. We're coming down the wire here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Bunnell hands off for Radcliffe. Bunnell glides in. Bunnell dices. Benedette tried to play it up towards the point. Benedette having a very good game. And looking for more. Off from Radcliffe. Low underneath, sneaks through Sheehan. Borshev holds it, plays it for Radcliffe. 9:40 the time remaining. Power play expires. But Danbury's power play woes continue. Radcliffe steps to the circle. Traffic collapses. Radcliffe will play it for Sheehan. Fans on the puck. Radcliffe up for DeBenedette. Borshev will handle it. Igor Borshev lost it, kicked along the wall. Kuznetsov will pick it off. DeBenedette at the circle. Wanted to play it along and couldn't. Locked down. Yao up to Kuznetsov. Pocket picked. Here comes Campbell. 3-on-2. Kuznetsov into the mix now. Campbell tried to dice through. Amesbury stood his ground. Golov keeps it at the point. Robertson can't do anything with it. They get the clear. Amesbury ahead to Ruiz. Ruiz taking on the defense, 1-on-2, springs free, misses the puck completely. He overswung on the shot. They'll try it again. Amesbury drops the puck up at the point. Kuznetsov low for McDonald, in tight. Puck goes behind the goal. 8:15 to play. Tied up at 4. Benedette will play it across for McDonald. Pass is tipped. Wild can't control it. Radcliffe could. Thrown across the blue line. 8 minutes left. It is worth noting now, the Columbus River Dragons have fallen to the Carolina Thunderbirds 3-1. With that result, the Danbury Hat Tricks are the regular season champions for the Federal Prospects Hockey League for the 2022-23 season. I'll repeat that again. A 3-1 final, it looks like. Ruiz walks in, shot off the glove of Thomas Proudlaw. 7:15 left to go. Flipped up, Ruiz will catch it and handle it. Ruiz will walk in, blast it, and Proudlock read it all the way. We'll take the under 10 media timeout, come back in a moment from the Danbury Ice Arena here in the Danbury Hat Tricks YouTube channel. Friends at Diversified Printing Solutions. Based in Danbury, they're the Hat Trick's official printing partner. You want it printed? Call Tina and let them get it inked up for you. DPS Printing Solutions, they can do it all. Locally owned and printed on paper from Connecticut trees. Up to the point, Hat Trick's and Mammoth tied up at 4 goals apiece. Puck sits on the apron, tried to whack at it. And nothing there. Separating everybody for. Borshevelhop on the faceoff dot. Dwyer thought it was going off to the penalty box. Yep, thought he was heading off. He'll hop back to the bench. Who's gonna take this faceoff? It'll be Kyle Stevens who does it. Draw down. Amesbury trying to hammer it away. Borshev, smart decision to just cover it up. Shots currently 50-29 in Danbury's favor. Benedetta again on the draw. Gonzalez will take it for a walk. Radcliffe. There's a goal tonight. Marcius on the tip. It almost sneaks through Proudlock, and he covers it up. Yao, he'll settle it and work it deep. Puck bounces, Proudlock in, scores! Michael Marchessault, 5-4, Danbury! This is the result of a terrible bounce. Tried to get the clear. Played here, bounced in front. Proudlock got a stick on it, and Marchessault throws the puck on net and in. 5-4 the score with 6:29 left to go. Danbury trying to make good and end the home regular season with a victory. Pass for McKittrick, that's played with a high stick. And that is gonna end up being ruled as an icing. That was an illegally played puck.
Patrick fans, out of town scoreboard. The final score from Columbus, Georgia. Carolina Thunderbirds 3, the Columbus River Dragons 1.
A Carolina score has been announced in-house. .6:15 left to go. They're deliberating about where this puck is gonna be. They're gonna say it was an inadvertent or incorrectly ruled icing. So we'll get a center ice face-off. Michael Marchessault with the goal. His second of the game. That gives him 32 goals this season.
And there he goes! Scored by number 88, Michael Marchessault! Assisted by number 4,
thrown on net, kicked. Jared Yao will get a second assist. Bunnell tying up Gullo. Here we go. And takes him down. We get another little tie-up. Gullo, Wild now gets his gloves off. It's Wild, not Gullo. Bunnell trading punches. Helmets off. And Bunnell walks away with the victory. They look like they want to go a little more. Ruiz embraces Bunnell. This is quite a showcase and quite a performance they've put on. Through all the penalties and all the mess, Brian Wilson has stopped 25 shots. We're now under 6 minutes left to go. Luke Richards with a 4-point game. Lucas DeBenedette with 3 points, and Michael Marchesson with 3 points as well, two of them goals. Tricks fans rise to their feet. This is a replay of that fight. Wow. Quite a show. Draw one. Hamileano working around the boards. Off the glass, Amesbury trying to cheat ahead. Can't connect with the puck. Borshev can't work it free. Schmidt gives chase in his own end. Fighting majors given to Gordy Bunnell and Noah Wild. Wilson with another stop. 5:19 to go in the third.
Time of penalties, 14 minutes, 12 seconds in the third period. Bunnell and Wild fighting penalties at 14-12.
Point shot, fanned on it by Campbell. Turning and firing, and they've scored again. Stevens puts it in the top corner, and we're tied at 5. The Elmira Mammoth, from the perspective of the hat tricks, playing an annoyingly persistent game and refusing to go away. We're getting every sort of effort you could ever want in this game tonight. In off the glass, Wilson will settle it. And the hat tricks poured in all that effort to take the lead, and now they have to do it again. 6-5 would have to be the winning margin right now. Marchesson back on sides. Drops it for Radcliffe, his shot blocked up top. Oh, for Marchesson, he'll carry it on. Marchesson scores again! Seconds after the lead is gone! Marchesson with the hat trick! Wow! The lids are on the ice! Marchesson, two goals late here in the third. And only a few seconds. An unbelievable turn of events. The lids come on the ice. You'll see it again. This is the play, dragged around, put it home. His hat trick goal, his 33rd goal of the season. And once more, Danbury trying to hold on to a lead. Whacked in and blocked off of Proudlock's pads. 4:30 left to go. Robertson will poke it out to neutral.
Assisted by number 55, Nathan Campbell, and number 47, Kyle Stevens.
Campbell and Stevens get the assist on the most recent goal, on the mammoth goal. That's actually being awarded to Stephen Ford, and is where that goal is going. Loose puck right in front. McKittrick tried to punch it home, didn't have it. Michael Marchessault, Jared Yao, and Lucas DeBenedet get the goal and assists, respectively.
And there he goes, his third of the game. Scored by number 88, Michael Marchessault.
Sheehan in front. Sheehan will pull up at the circle.
Yeah.
Leave it low, low for Amesbury. Worked on. Danbury trying to end the season with only four losses, two in regulation and two in overtime. Here at home this regular season, a wonderful effort. Borshev to Amesbury, his shot stopped by Proudlock. Has made 50 plus saves. 3:15 the time remaining. Amesbury will play it backwards for Pamaleon. Keep an eye on that net. Be curious to see when Proudlock heads to the bench for the extra attacker. We're coming up on 3 minutes left. McDonald fans on it. Wanted to play it on. Borshev steps through. Igor Borshev wanted the wraparound, didn't have the angle. Played up for McDonald. Shot on. Blocker save made by Proudlock. He's at 50 for the night. On it in front, it's picked by Soilus. This will be left against the wall. 2:35 left to go. Marchessault will hold it and work it forward. Bouncing puck, Proudlock will put it away in his mitt. We'll take the final media timeout of the game. Brief pause, back in a moment with the final 2:26 of the game here on the Danbury Hatcherings YouTube channel. It's the spirit of hard work. The Batchers of Litchfield Distillery, in honor of the early farmers of Northwest Connecticut, present to you the locally made Litchfield Distillery bourbon, vodka, and gin. Grab it at the rabbit hole and hoist the barrel with the hat tricks. .226 the time remaining. Lucas DeBenedet on the faceoff dot. Tries to win it, played up for McKittrick. Radcliffe in front, DeBenedet, he scores! A 4-point game, a 5-point game now for Lucas DeBenedet. He'll go through the crowd and wave to the fans. 7-5 for the hat tricks with 2:18 to go. This is a pretty quick and easy shot. DeBenedet up to the point. Yao to the wall. Up top, circled shot, top right corner, and a goal. Goodness. Long pass ahead. Campbell will run on. Campbell drags, shot, save made. Wilson covers. .207 left. Proudlock has left the net. It is empty. Elmira needs to score two goals in the last 2 minutes and 7 seconds. Elmira calls for time. The scoring on the most recent Danbury goal is as follows. Lucas DeBenedet the goal, Radcliffe the assist, and Jared Yao the secondary assist. 2 minutes, 7 seconds left. Five points for Lucas DeBenedet. 4 points for Jacob Radcliffe. Two goals and three assists for a brilliant night for Lucas DeBenedet. Again, the net is empty.
Goal scored by number three, Lucas DeBenedet. Assisted by number four.
Net is empty at that end, but the puck is ice.
And number four, Jared.
Jared Yao also getting an assist on that goal. It's his third assist of the game. Yao came into this one with 33 points and 31 assists. He'll walk away with 36 points on 34 assists. Abdullah will work it around for Marchessault. He'll try and play it forward. Stevens will settle it. A minute and 44 left to go. Again, the Elmira net is empty. D'Angelo can't do anything on it. Along the wall, pulls up at the circle. Dip backwards, turns, wanted to shoot it, blocked. Abdullah will play it to the wall. Stevens will do much more with it than that. Richards will fling it on, locked down. Gonzalez up to Kuznetsov. Marchessault controls it. Marchessault in and pots the empty netter. 4 goals for Michael Marchessault. This one pretty straightforward. Got to it in the corner. Pass up the wall. Marchessault in and buries it. The Danbury hat tricks with an 8-goal game. The Kittrick will carry it across the blue line. Picked off. Elmira will try it again. It's the third 4-goal game in the history of the Danbury Hat Tricks franchise. Borshev will walk it on. Amesbury, the shot kicks off the bottom of the wall. We'll get a little bit more pushing and shoving here as Robertson gonna get into it. .4 left. An 8-5 game. An unbelievable offensive performance by the Hat Tricks here in the third period. What are we deliberating on exactly, fellas? Daniel Amesbury is sitting down for a two-minute minor penalty with 26.4 seconds left. But at this point, that's just the coda to the game. 5 points each for Lucas DiBenedetto and Michael Marchessault. It's the third four-goal game in the history of the franchise. Dustin Gesso had one in the 21-22 season. Johnny Ruiz had one earlier this season.
Number 14, Daniel Amesbury.
And Michael Marchessault joins that esteemed list. And in one of the most incredible games at the very end of the season, this remarkable team clinches the regular season championship of the Federal Prospects Hockey League, the Danbury Hattricks. Take this final 8-5. And the road to the Commissioner's Cup goes over the Hatted Rabbit in downtown Hat City.
The final score.
5 points each for Lucas DiBenedetto and Michael Marchessault. That ties them for the second most points in a single game in the history of the franchise.
Fans, please bring your attention to center ice.
Schmidt comes over to have a chat with Billy McCreary. No ill will between those guys, just respect and good hockey efforts. Michael Marchessault, of course, lifts the Litchfield Distillery barrel. Danbury has two more regular season games to play. They will head on the road. They'll get together for a quick team photo.
And stick around for the three stars of the game.
They'll bring the trainer, they'll bring Zaskion Wilson as well, hopping in, making sure he takes a knee. The 2022-23 regular season champion, Danbury Hattricks, will skate a lap the Danbury Ice Arena, rocking, rolling, and any team hoping to win the championship has to deal with this team in orange. It's the 42nd win of the season. Elmira drops to 14, 33 and 6. Danbury's record 41, 7 and 5. The Hattricks complete the home season 24, 2 and 2. A remarkable, complete show for Danbury. 32 saves for Brian Wilson. 50 saves by Thomas Proudlock. One shot on goal in the empty net. And now the three stars
and
of the game.
The three stars of the game. Tonight's third star from the Hattricks, with one goal and three assists.
4 points.
Number 44, Jacob Radcliffe.
For number 44, Jacob Radcliffe. 4 points for the night. The second star of the game.
Tonight's second star from the Hattricks, with one goal and three assists. Number three, Lucas
DiBenedetto, two-goal game, three assists, 5 points for the International Falls Minnesota native, And of course,
first star from the hat tricks with 4 goals and 1 assist, number 88,
Michael Marchessault is the number one star tonight. 4 goals, 1 assist, 5 points.
Once again, your
an astonishing effort. And the hat tricks secure the regular season championship in the Federal Prospect Hockey League. They'll begin the playoffs on April the 21st. They have 2 more regular season games to go. Feels like a bit of a coda to the season, but they're going to treat it as though it's a business trip. They'll go to Port Huron and play 2 games against the Prowlers next Friday and Saturday. First game of the playoffs will be the 21st on the road, most likely against these Elmira Mammoth. And the final game of the season. The Danbury Hat Tricks will open up the postseason on the 21st of April. They'll be on the road, most likely at Elmira. And game 2 will be April the 22nd, right here at the Danbury Ice Arena. And I want to personally thank everybody for tuning in and enjoying the Danbury Hat Trick season along with me this whole season. It's been a great ride, and there's more to go in the playoffs. So that's it. And also worth noting, we, the broadcast team for the Hat Tricks, will be traveling with the team for every single playoff game for the duration of the postseason. So wherever they go, you'll be able to watch the entire 2022-23 Commissioner's Cup Chase for the Danbury Hat Tricks here on the Danbury Hat Tricks YouTube channel. That's it. For everybody here with the Danbury Hat Tricks, I'm Chris Lynch. We hope you have enjoyed your time with us this evening. Be warm, be well, wherever you may be.